So whenever you're playing a game on your PC, how many times does the perfectionist inside you looks at the corner of the screen and just doesn't like the FPS that you're getting? I remember back in the day when I literally had a hard time trying to figure out how to even check the FPS, so I ended up downloading some malware, I guess. These days, however, the FPS counter for gaming on PC can come in wide variety. It is either already a toggle in game, it's on the Steam overlay or on Nvidia's or AMD's overlay, or maybe even your monitor has one. So anyway, I did a poll recently and it seems like a lot of you like to keep it turned on all the time, and you may be one of those people, especially if you got some new hardware. Now ask yourself this question: why is it that even after knowing how much FPS you're going to get, you still want to keep the FPS counter on all the time? Is it because you just want to make sure you're getting the right amount of FPS because it gives you some sort of a mental satisfaction? Think about it. Whatever the case is, unless you are debugging or benchmarking, you may be doing it wrong. Let me explain. In the past, I had been keeping the FPS counter on whenever I can, all the time. I would do it for all the games that I purchased. So my reason, or should I say excuse for doing this, would be to make sure if I'm getting the right amount of FPS. And since I recently got a 3060 Ti and a 144Hz monitor, it makes sense, right? Like whenever I would launch a game, I would always make sure to tweak the graphics settings in a way so that the number is always at least 144. Now here's the thing, in the beginning when you just get a game, it makes sense because you wanna tune things out and see if the game would even run on your GPU. But anything after that, the FPS counter might be just a distraction. Like recently, while playing Red Dead Redemption 2, instead of focusing deeply on the beauty of the game, I would at times keep my eye on the top left of the screen and make sure if I'm getting at least 60 FPS all the time. Anything less would trigger my brain to do something about it. I used to think it was just me, but then I heard the same from my friend who recently got a new laptop. So whenever we would play Fortnite, yes, we still do that. Instead of just focusing on the fun the game had to offer, there would be several times where we'd say, hey, I'm getting less FPS, or there are more FPS drops, hey, this season has worse performance issues, and more stuff like that. But one day, and everything changed. So I was playing Lost City on my iPhone 13 Pro, which I got recently, and so I wanted to try 120Hz gaming on that thing. And so I fired up the game, and here's the blockbuster. I was not able to tell if the game was locked at 60 frames or 120. Now before we take on that, here's a word from our wonderful sponsor, Salad. Salad is the best way to make the most out of your gaming PC or laptop by letting it earn rewards for you, such as Discord Nitro, Amazon gift cards, Steam gift cards or games, and even more. The way this works is through crypto mining, which might make you question, is it safe? Well, yes. There's a detailed guide about it, which I'll link below, and to add up, they're officially partnered by Discord themselves. You can check out their source code on GitHub, as well as read their Trustpilot reviews if you wish to. Salad works best when you're not doing anything on your PC, like say when you're sleeping, or just doing something else like web browsing. So whenever you're ready, head over to the link in the description, download Salad, sign up, and use my code PRI while doing so to double your income for quite some time. If you have any doubts, you may check out the other links in the description for the same. People out there are claiming something for themselves every minute. So what are you waiting for? Download Salad today. Now for a guy like me who is always very conscious about these numbers, I was surprised not to be able to tell a difference between 60 or 120 FPS when there's obviously a major difference. And so I thought, maybe let's do an experiment. What if I just never turn on the FPS counter unless something felt really wrong? And this was one of the smallest yet best things I've done in order to improve my gaming experience. So recently I bought Resident Evil Village in the Steam sale. I fired up the game, didn't even touch the FPS counter, it was turned off all the time. And I have to say, I've never really enjoyed a single player game this much in a long time without worrying about what my FPS might be. Now of course this may sound like an extreme take as I did not even turn it on in the beginning, but sticking to what I said before, it was just a matter of unless something felt really wrong, and nothing felt wrong here. Now for this video's sake, I checked later and I was getting around 90 to 100 FPS on the highest settings. And if I knew this somehow earlier, I know I would have tried to play with the settings instead of the game for quite a while. And even after doing so, I would leave that ugly counter thing on the top of my screen. Now I realize, of course, anyone who has a lower end PC will probably feel the shutter, and in that case I totally recommend and would have myself monitored the FPS and tweaked the settings. But then do not forget to turn it off later, as keeping it just there is counterintuitive and will not make it better than it already is. The verdict is, there will be more times when you'll notice the slight FPS drops because of that counter rather than actually seeing it happening with the game. And so do this, and trust me, this will make your games much more enjoyable. Yes, even if it is just a small counter like the one Steam offers. This is also probably why consoles never offer a system-wide setting for such a thing. Now since you're here till the end, let me know your thoughts. Now you might have something similar to say about ping. While ping is a similar form of data, it is only there on multiplayer games, and it may have more tendency to be variable only if you're using Wi-Fi, but on Ethernet, it is always pretty stable. I like how many games don't even have any option to show the ping counter all the time, but instead, they put it on the scoreboard that only comes by pressing a button like tab. So while ping is a different case, it can also be a distraction at times. Like I do remember many times when sudden ping increases happened, I would miss out on many potential clutches in CSGO. But since multiplayer games already have too much to focus on, ping isn't something I'm gonna talk about more in this video, cause that's a totally different thing now. But what if your friend was on Mars and you were still on Earth and wanted to play a game together? Check out this video, and until next week, thanks for watching.